What if I told you that you can make instant WordPress sites that are disposable or reserved? Plus, I can show you how to make cash with this. This is InstaWP, and I'm going to show you how it works right now. What's up, SaaS Masters? My name is George, and we're going to check out InstaWP. Now, they have a free plan that you can check out, which is totally useful. Now, if you need features that the free plan doesn't have, go ahead and check out the pricing. They have an affordable plan, which is personal with $6, professional $29, and agency for $79. But like I said, the free plan is great for 3 active sites, which is totally workable if you want to create instant sites to start testing or dispose right away. Okay, now let's jump over to my InstaWP dashboard. Now, this is where the magic starts. Now, you have your sites, your templates, your connects, your hosting, and your WAAS. But in this case, that means that you can make money out of this. Now, let me get started with the simple features, and we'll jump over to the WAAS feature, okay? Now, when you are creating a site, it's super easy, okay? So let's just say I want to create a reserve site or a disposable site because I need to do some testing. I need to make sure that a plugin works and it won't break my site. Well, that is possible. Click on Add New. And in Add New, this is how you're going to get started. So you can start from scratch, use a template, or the store. Now, in this case, we're going to start from scratch, and you have the possibility to add previously plugins once you get started. So, for example, these are the popular plugins, security plugins. Now, I usually install WordFence, the SEO. I usually start Yoast SEO. There's SEO Press also, another type of SEO plugins. Speed, your cache plugins. In this case, I use W3 Total Cache, so this is great for me. Forms, I use my own form, so I won't install one. Backups plugin, again, I install my own, but I can use one of these. Page builders, I use Elementor and Brizzy. In this case, I'll use Elementor, for example. Marketing plugins, utility, e-commerce. In this case, I do want WooCommerce on this site. And translation, Wiglet. In this case, I'm not going to use it, okay? Now, it's going to install WordPress 6.3.1, but in this case, we'll keep it like it is, okay? A PHP version, I want to use the latest version, 8.2, because let's just say, hypothetically, I want to make sure that something works in that PHP version, okay? The site name, now it's important that you use a unique name because it might be tied to another one and it won't let you install it. So I'll just say, test for a video, 1, 2, 3, et cetera, just like that. And if I want to make a reserve site, depending on my plan, that means it won't get deleted in 7, 15 days, et cetera, depending on the plan that you're on. So I'll create the site, okay? And the installation is in progress. So that means that that demo site is going to be installed right now with the plugins that I decided I want to use, okay? Now that's going to be done really quickly, and here we go. It's ready. So that was really fast, right? Now I have the link that I can go to the site. So let's go ahead and check this out. Here we go. Here's the WordPress site. I have the credentials to log into the backend of the WordPress site to start working on it, testing it, etc. My username and password, the DB editor, code editor, and the view logs. And there's a magic link. This is super useful. So I click on the magic link, and it'll automatically take me to the backend of the WordPress site. So I don't need to enter credentials manually. So it's a time saver, okay? And here we go. Let me get rid of that. Again, now it's the WooCommerce, so I'll skip the guide. Okay, so here we go. All that nonsense is gone. So here's my dashboard, here's my WordPress installation with the plugins I decided I wanted to get installed beforehand so I can get started right away. I don't want to set up WordFence right now. And here we go. I decided I wanted Elementor, W3 Total Cache, WooCommerce, WordFence, and Yoast SEO. So all that was installed right away so I can start testing right away with this. So it's super useful, okay? I'm going to get rid of that. So like I said, it's super easy that way. Now, there's a ton of features once you have a WordPress site installed. You can auto-log in. You can reserve the site so it doesn't get deleted. You can save the template so you can use it later on. You can add tags so you can find this later on. And in the filter, you can filter these. Once you have a bunch of sites, this is really useful. And there's several options available. You need to change PHP version, you can do that. View credits, migrate to V2, commands, export as, tools, deployment, surfix, clone, delete, SFTP credentials, SSH credentials, and map domain. So all that is possible with this. I mean, it's super useful. Now, once you've created your sites, you can head on over to templates. You can create templates right here or save as templates. So you have your private templates and you have your shared templates, however you want to use this. So for example, I'm going to edit this one that I created already, which is my Woo template. And I give it my template name. I can give it a description, instant template. I can upgrade to unlock that, the language. So these are the 3 languages available. The branding for this, it's my logo, which I uploaded. customize email. So in this case, I didn't customize it at all, but you're gonna get an email like this. You got your logo and you got your details here. So it's powered by InstaWP, but in that case, I can edit that, which is this right here. So if I wanna get rid of that, I can say powered by SaaS Master, et cetera. That is possible. The privacy policy, the custom CSS, custom colors. Next, we have the gallery. Gallery, I'll show you how that looks. So in this case, I just took a screenshot of a site, but you can add some really nice, fancy looking websites because once you go to the link of the template, let me go over here, it's gonna look like this. So if you have several images, you can go through these. So this is just a ordinary screenshot, but I can launch a demo right from here. So if I wanna share a link for someone to use, it's easy, okay? I can launch a demo, I can put up my credentials, I'll just wing it here. Subscribe to the mailing list, in this case, not right now. Purchase site, this is a free site. You can see right here, purchase successful, and it's gonna start the installation right away. And I'm gonna get the email with the credentials also. So just like that, all right? So you can make money with this. Let's get rid of this for now. You got your advanced options here. So site lifetime, this site that is gonna be the demo site that you can create really easily via that link. I can set how many hours or days I want this to actually work. So if you have a site where you're a developer, something like that, and you want someone to test this out, or if you're selling some kind of plugin or a theme, et cetera, you can have them test it out for a certain period of hours or days, okay? Collect email, so depending if you wanna enable that, enable site cloning, redirect URL, webhook URL, connect email provider, and post creation commands. All that is available. Now, like I said, you can monetize this or you can set it for free. Now, if you are having someone test something for you, free is fine, but if you wanna make cash, that is possible with this. And you have, like you said, your own link with your logo, your branding, your emails and all of that, and it's sent over there. You can view your sales right here. So two of these have been installed, 0 because I set it for free. Here's the site details and the status, and you can view the store here. Now, all that is super cool, right? You can make money right away, but you can make more money also with WAAS. Let's go into Connect. Now you can install sites from here. For example, you can connect the site through your live website URL, and you can download the plugins. So you can have that imported and be connected one with another. That's pretty cool, right? It's a feature that's super useful depending your use case, okay? Hosting, you can actually host your sites that you've created here in your hosting provider. So in this case, I use Server Avatar, but you can connect another hosting provider. So for example, there's WP Cloud, Run Cloud, Cloudways, WP Bolt, Pressable, Server Avatar, which I'm using, SignUpWP. If you're looking for another one, do hit that in the comments so the creators can actually look at it, okay? Now, like I said, I've connected Server Avatar via API, and these are my servers that I have available, and I can use these. I can go ahead and connect a new site with one of my hostings that I have available here, okay? Now, for the WAAS, WordPress as a service, okay? So I've created this WAAS store, and the template that I'm using is the Woo template. That's how I connected it, and the hosting plan, it's the default plan. I can edit all the details for this. So like I said, I'm using this template and go next. And this is like going through the steps of setting up your WAAS, okay? As for payment in the beginning, I set this off, but if you wanna charge for this, you enable that. Skip InstaWP demo site creation. So if you wanna do that, that is possible. I'll leave this off. Next, it's the plans that you're going to create. So in this case, I created the default plan, or I can say free plan, okay? And it's free, okay? It's tied to my server with Server Avatar. I select the server, which is SaaSWP, which is a certain BPS that I have, and the feature that this plan has. So I say starter, and I have the features here, free to use, full features, edit plugins, etc. And just add features there and add another plan here. This is a new plan, and I can set my short description. So I'll just say premium plan. Here we go, features. New features, I'll just leave it like that. You can add more features, settings. So this is going to be the premium plan, and it's gonna be paid, and it's gonna tie to my SaaSWP server, and I'll go next. My logo, my branding colors, background colors, I'm good to go. Next, I can go ahead and review everything. Everything is fine. I'll select finish, and boom, okay? So now let's go check out this site. Let's go to preview, and here we go. So just like that, you can share this link to someone, and they can choose a template. So I'll choose this one. I'll choose the free one. I'll go continue. My name, email. I'll just set something random there. Continue. It's going to start the installation process right away, and I'll get in the email all the information for that. So it's super easy to use, okay? If I want to create a new WAAS, I'll just add new, and it's super easy, okay? If I want to check my analytics and my plan subscription, I can view the amount of sites I have right now in my pro subscription, my disk storage, restore sites, get operations, templates, and template sites. So all that is available there. So that is InstaWP. Like I said, if you want to check out the free plan and if that is useful for you, go ahead and grab it and test it out. And if you want to jump into the paid plan for those extra features, I think it's totally worth it and it's not expensive. So I do recommend InstaWP. Go check it out. Link will be provided in the description. And that's a wrap.